हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द ऑनलाइन लेक्चर सीरीज ऑफ द एसडीएसएम कॉलेज पालघर। टुडे वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग विद द सेम चैप्टर पेस्ट एंड डिसीज कंट्रोल विद द सेकंड पार्ट। आई एम विलास सर एंड वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर टुडेज सेशन। सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द प्रिंसिपल्स एंड मेथड्स ऑफ पेस्ट एंड डिसीज कंट्रोल इन द टुडेज सेक्शन। If we talk about the principles and the methods to control the pest, so there are the success. Sustainable pest management depends on their knowledge of the strategy, pest biology and the pest ecology of the agro ecosystem part. So the development of the active pest control strategy is reliant and the contingent on the different types of the methods. If you talk about the correct identification of the pest and its status, determining the pest as per the seasonal effect, knowledge of the available control and tactics, timings which are conducting in the techniques for targeting site of a pest, the determination of the choice of the pest goal. So there are the different plannings and commitment which should be aware that farmers who face these challenges in every season. So in that controlling part, some principles are taken. First, maybe the prevention of the pest and pathogens, avoiding the entry of the pest and pathogen, removal of the and the description of the pest and their diseases, chemical control of the pest and the diseases, development or the production of the pest or disease resistant plant. So there are some different methods on pest control: the cultural control method, mechanical method, physical method, legal methods, biological method and the chemical methods which are applied. In that we will talk about the cultural control method. Some techniques or tactics are needful. The as per the selection of the seed, clean cultivation, provision of the alternate host, crop rotation based, tillage operations, timing of planting and harvesting, cultivation of the trap crops, nutrient management. So the selection of the seed cultivation is needful. When the seed damaged by the insect or the pest, it is sown, it may cause a poor germination or the poor health in seedling time. So these seed resistant crop variety are used for the crop production at that time. There is a needful application are based on clean cultivation as well. So the disposal or the destruction of the crop residue removes the residue pest population which are the previously part of crops. In that, the pink bollworm larvae are destroyed. Talking about the mechanical control, in that, hand picking of infested plant, netting, bagging, dislodging of the insect pest, trenching, burning, hitting and crushing insect barrier and the mechanical extruder, insect trap and the provision of the bird perching objects are used in the mechanical control. Next, it is a physical method. In this method, some physical forces for eradication of the insects, example the kaolinite clay mixed with the stored grain. It includes some use of heat and moisture light. Fourthly, the legal method, the legislation or the laws to prevent the introduction of the new pest and their prevention are already established, and the regulation of the activities for the men engaged with the pest control operations. Talking about the biological methods, the pest is controlled by the means of another living organism that are encouraging and thus spread by the man is called biological control. In the natural enemies of insects, parasites and the predators, which are disease-causing viruses and bacteria, fungi, parasites, nematodes, are used to control that particular pest. Let's talk about the chemical methods in that. The various common pesticides are used to control the insects. The natural or the synthetic chemicals are directly causing the death or the repulsion or the attraction of the insects are used, and the in that pesticide it's a chemical or the mixture of the chemical which are employing for the killing pest, and this term pesticide is encompasses on insecticide, herbicide, rodenticide, that means killing the rat like species, fungicides and other substance. For the preparation of the spray solution, some quantity of insecticide are required with the treatment. Here we are using some chemical formula. It is N1V1 is equal to N2V2. It is nothing but the quantity of insecticide required is equal to total quantity of spray solution into the strength in the percentage of the spray solution desired divided by a strength of the chemical which are available. So the finding out the quantity of chlorpyrifos, it is a 20% EC which is required for the treatment of the area which is almost preparing the 1000 liters of the spray fluid, in that which have a 0.02% of the strength. So here we are using the same formula, N1V1 is equal to N2V2. So for the preparing the solution, we need to know what is the N1. So N1 is the strength of the chemical, where V1 is equal to quantity of insecticide, N2 is the strength of spray solution desired in the percentage, and the V2 is the total quantity of spray solution which is required. So we have a formula here. So we are interchanging the V1 at our left hand side. So we have given the N2 as well as the V2 and N1. So we putting the values for preparing the solution. This is the quantity of the insecticide, that means V1 is equal to 0.02 into 1000 liters divided by 20. It comes under 1 liter. That means we have to mix the 1 liter of the insecticide in the quantity of 1000 liters of the water to spraying that particular area. Some precautions should be taken care before the applying the pesticides. So select only proper insecticide of the fungicides. Keeping pesticide in their original container with the label. Read the carefully information about the precautions and the first aid. Store the pesticide beyond the reach of the children, away from the food to food material. Wear protective appliances while applying applications of the pesticides. Do not drink, eat or smoke while handling this pesticide. Do not use defective equipments. Spray along the wind direction, not the opposite direction. Wash all the equipments after handling the pesticides. Take care for the avoiding contamination of tanks, ponds, wells, as well as some water resources. And lastly, use pesticide in the appropriate concentration against the particular pest. Storage and the handling of the pesticide, which is very necessary. So these pesticides are the toxic in nature, so human being or the animal get affected or they can be fatal to the life. So they should be handled with the utmost with the care. So some precautions should be taken care while the handling of the pesticides. First, the pesticide should be always stored in the original containers. They should be stored away from the food, fodder or the medicines. They should be kept out of the reach of the children or the domestic animals. The containers of the pesticides should be cut open with a separate knife, and the empty container should be destroyed properly. The instructions should, which are found on the labels, should be strictly followed. Avoiding the contact of the pesticide with the skin or the clothing. Avoiding smoking, chewing, eating or drinking while the mixing or applying the chemicals or the pesticides. Make the spray or the dust in a cool or the calm weather and the direction of the wind. Sprayer nozzles should not blow by the mouth. The washing of the equipment or nearer the well or the street, it should be avoided. And lastly, the contaminated part should be buried. Let's talk about the disease control or the management. Some suitable measures should be taken to prevent the incidence of a disease, the spreading of the disease, and minimizing the loss caused by the disease. It is called as a control measures. The aim of the disease control is to check loss of economic gain from the crops. So it control measures fails to increase the economic gain even if the disease incidence is reduced. So the farmers will not accept any recommendation for the plant disease management. So the principle of the plant disease management have a two approach, like the management of the single disease of the crop and the planting for the overall health of the crops. Proper management and the planning for the disease is against a specific disease that causes the heavy loss without taking in the consideration of the disease from the same crops. Then the management of the crop health, which involving the plan in which all diseases of a crop are taken in the consideration. So the major stress may be against the severe disease. And the second approach, it is difficult for the farmers but have a more practical value. So talking about the general principle, first is the avoidance, which is involving the avoiding disease by planting time when or in area where the inoculums are absent or inefficient or effective due to the environmental conditions. So main practice are taken, the selection of the planting material, then the modification of the cultural practices, escaping varieties like different techniques, choices of the geographical area, selection of that particular field, and sowing and planting time. Secondly, exclusion. It restricts the movement of the disease plant material to the area free from the disease concern. Next is the eradication. It involves the elimination of the pathogen from the infested area or infected area. Fourthly, the protection. These measures are used to prevent onset of the diseases on the crop to protect the host from the attack by the pathogen. Lastly, the host resistance. The utilization of the particular method is to build mechanism to resist various activities of a pathogen and the infection of the particular damage can be rendered ineffective through the genetic manipulation or the chemotherapy. Lastly, the therapy. The various treatments are taken to the infected host plant. Talking about the methods of the disease control, first is the inclusion of the pathogen. In that, some area of a plant which are affected, which are should be quarantined. It is a legal method. Inspection of the and the certification, seed treatment and eradication of the insect vectors. Next, it is avoidance of the pathogen. In that, choice of geographical area, selection of the field, choice of time planting, disease escaping varieties and the selection of the seed and planting material are taken. Next, it is a eradication of the pathogen. In that, heat treatment is given. In heat treatment, seed or the stock tools and the implements of the soil are taken. Next is the biological. In that, antagonist, hyperparasite, mycorrhizae, cross protection and the control of the weeds on and the pest are used. Next is the cultural practice. In that, farmers practices crop rotations, fertilizer application, storage, disinfection, sanitation and the removal of the destructed or the destruction of the diseased plant. Next is the chemical control. Here again the cultural methods are used. In the cultural methods, first it is the crop rotation is taken. While the growing of the crops which are host of the pest in the successive manner of the result in increasing the population of that particular pest. So this crop rotation with non-host crop is done. The population of the pest is reduced because of the insect is excluded from it and the food supply. Example, the ladyfinger followed by the cotton crop suffered from a increase of the pest infection at the same time. Next is the mixed cropping. In this mixed cropping, the intention for the getting some return from the area if one crop is attacked by other is escapes. In mixed cropping, the pigeon pea and the sorghum is giving the significant reduction in the incidence of the wilting of pigeon pea. Next is sanitation. After the destruction of the crops, the debris are burned and the field decreases the parasite effect. So the sanitation is very much important when the disease crop residue are left behind. Let's talk about the chemical control. In this chemical control method, this method is protective toxic layer on the host surface is formed so that the pathogen comes in contact which are killed and prevented from the growth. After spraying and the dusting of a fungicides, it protects the plants from the infectious diseases and the chemicals which acts externally and destroy the organism on the plant surface which act from within or a systemic manner which eliminates the pathogen which is already establishing the host. These fungicides are the chemical capping fungi. And these fungi, based on their mode of the action of the particular group of fungus. So the protectant are used in that fungicides which are very much effective is only if applied prior to the fungicidal infection. So these are known as a protectant. Example is the sulfur. Next is the therapeutant. Some fungicides having the capacity to eradicate the fungus after it has caused infection. Here it used carboxin as a fungicides. Next is the eradicant. In that, the chemicals which are removing the pathogenic fungi from the infectious coat. Here we are using the organic mercurial. Next is the systemic fungicides. In that, any compound which are capable from freely translocating after the penetration of a plant is called systemic fungicides, and these type of fungicides which could be eradicating the establishment of the infectious or the which protects from the plant part. Here we are using again carboxin and the benlet. And next is the antibiotics. Some antibiotics which are very much helpful, and these are the chemical substance which are again reducing the growth of the microorganisms on the plant, which inhibit or the kill microorganism